Welcome back everybody to another video. This is less of a tutorial and more of a demonstration on creating a very quick scene. This scene took about 10 minutes to make total, and it's just a quick test to see how well these prefabricated elements that I've created over the past month actually hold up. So far, the first impressions look good. I have spent quite a lot of time making each of these individual models and elements, texturing and UV mapping each of them. It has been quite painful, but the end result so far, as far as I know, has been very, very good. I'm quite pleased with it. And the idea here is to get to a point where I can create a scene relatively quickly. And like I said, this took about 10 minutes to make, so I would definitely say it has been a success at some level. But the idea, all I'm doing here is just creating a scene from, just improvising, completely improvising. I haven't planned anything, I haven't drawn any concept art for this. All I really have was just taking a look at a few assets online and just, in essence, drawn some inspiration from games or other short films and gone from there. So these elements have taken about a month or so to make. Most of them don't really take as long as people may think. You can actually do quite a large number of objects in a day or two. And I have spent some time putting some tutorials, and I'll probably put more up later down the track. But you can see that when you get to a point where you can drag and drop your assets in, the speed of your workflow is just unbelievably quick. It's simply a matter of just dragging, dropping them in, rotating, scaling, and adjusting objects wherever you like. And it does pay off for you to keep your elements and UV texture them properly and just make sure all of those tiny little elements look good on paper, because you can, once you've created them, once you get that right, you don't really have to worry too much about remaking those elements again down the track. You can just reuse them over and over and over again, and it does come out quite well. So it's very useful to save your objects and models for later use down the track. The other thing I do want to note is, if you probably don't notice this, you probably actually can't notice it, but all the wood elements have been created with just 10 small planks of wood. You've seen this in another video tutorial that I've created, and these 10 planks of wood have been reused over and over again in Photoshop. The illusion of variety is quite well. It does quite well. So don't underestimate creating simple things like pieces of wood, planks of wood for future use, because they do come in handy. And for me to get that same effect, what I've done is simply just adjusted the color and made it slightly darker or slightly brighter depending on what I want, change the hue and saturation until I get something that I actually like. So most of the wood, in fact pretty much all the wood elements in there, have just been reused from one simple texture. And it does pay off to keep those little things. Don't make one and throw them away. Just keep them for future use, because it will come in handy down the track. So far this entire scene has taken about eight, I think we're hitting the 8 minute mark right about now. This entire video has been sped up 2 times, so it's really quick, really efficient, and well, in essence you have saved yourself a lot of just hours. In fact, I probably wouldn't mind losing this particular save file, because it just takes, it doesn't take very long to create anyway. And once I've got the layout, all the objects in, I can just drag and drop in some lights. The lights system is a very simple 3-point lighting system, and it's basically one key light and 2 blue fill lights in the back. I'll probably make another video demonstration of that a little bit down the track. And of course I have a point light up there, that just to simulate a lantern above them with a little bit of a decay. I've put a linear decay in there just to give it that extra effect of, realism. So there you have it guys, a 10 minute scene, very quick to do, very efficient if you have created all your elements properly. And once you have them in your scene, you pretty much are ready to start whatever animation you want. So again, this has been a demonstration of a quick speed set creation. I hope you've enjoyed this, and please do subscribe if you like this content, and I will definitely see you guys next time.